Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me. At 8:30 this morning near Sedungo, Colorado, I'm probably pronouncing that wrong, not far from Trinidad, there was a magnitude 3.5 earthquake that 9 people said they felt. The shake map gave it an intensity level of 5. But over here for the community internet intensity, they gave it an intensity level of 4. So let me go down here and I'll show you, which is surprising. They would have an intensity level of 5, which means they would probably have some breakage. It says Trinidad. Now, intensity level 5 means it was felt by most people. There would have been some breakage. So if you happen to be watching my video, what kind of things broke? Was it windows or dishes? Things fell off the wall? Maybe cracks in your plaster, or tall objects that fell over. So that was intensity level 5 right there. Weston intensity level 3. Another one from Weston, intensity level 2. Trinidad intensity level 2. And another one from Trinidad, intensity level 3. Now, this should upset some people because this is the Spanish Peaks State Wildlife Area. Notice all the dots. Yeah, we got oil and gas production going on. Let me bring this out a little bit. Over here, we got Trinidad. On February 1st, there was a 3.1 close to this same area. Let's see, a 2.9, that was last year. Don't mark all the earthquakes, so there probably has been more. So we got the Spanish Peaks State Wildlife Area. So that should be a protected area, I would think. So here I found an article, I believe it's from 2011. Shale, oil, and gas has been cleared to drill deep into a unique geological formation near the Spanish Peaks in southern Colorado to explore new natural gas resources. Huerfano County planning and elected officials gave the exploratory fracking project a conditional green light last week, to the dismay of many local residents who are clamoring for more upfront research and better safeguards against the environmental impacts. Well, they're causing earthquakes. This latest earthquake was only 1.6 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. The Colorado Oil and Gas Conservation Commission last month denied a citizen request for a public hearing because the request didn't come from any local government entry. To my knowledge, this is the first fracking operation on the Front Range of Colorado, says Sandy Borthick, member of the citizens group, which presented a request for 7 safeguards to the Huerfano Planning and Zoning Commission. Sounds like another corrupt, office, whatever you want to call them. The approval process was fraught with controversy as the Planning and Zoning Commission refused to let members of the public speak at a preliminary meetings on the approval. Scott King, a chair of the commission, threatened to forcibly remove citizens from the meetings, according to C.O. Smith of the San Lucas Valley Renewable Committee Alliance. And to show you just how arrogant these people are, when the audience members protested this action, King responded with, "So sue us," according to Smith. Yeah, are they elected officials? Here they have an image of hydraulic fracturing. Shows you, you know, where they bring out the gas, where they pump the water in, etc. The primary concern of Levada citizens and residents is the potential for groundwater pollution and dangerous air emissions. So this is a wildlife area. And look at all the roads, look at all the platforms that they have put in within the last 11 years. Yeah, I wonder how many deer and other animals it might have disrupted. Yeah, look at that. It's just amazing. Utterly amazing. Yeah, it's always about the money, isn't it? Anyways, yeah, look at all those little dots. What are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And as always, be safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.